This is a DIY isolation transformer inside black box. In this video, I will show you how to make it by using the recycled parts. Step by step. These are the parts from a microwave oven transformer, dismantled by using an angle grinder to cut sides of core. No needs these original coils, however DIY coils will be made. This is a set of core from microwave oven. A bit of more needed for this DIY isolation transformer. And add those from the spare. Newly made core as a set will seat on a plate like this. These are the handmade materials for DIY bobbin. And the core area is 3.5 cm times 7.6 cm. That is the recycled winding wire of AWG number 20 for this isolation transformer. Maximum current is 2 amperes. This is a DIY made bobbin looks like. Another one with the same size will be made. Here we go. Two bobbins have been made. The primary and secondary winding use the same wire as AWG number 20. The wire diameter equals 0.81 millimeters. This is DIY made, the primary coil of 380 turns for 240 volt input. There is a marking on the bobbin. Black wire is for neutral and red wire is for live. That is DIY made. The secondary coil of 363 turns for voltage range between 220 and 230 volt isolated. Well, right now the primary coil and secondary coil have been fixed into core's windows nicely. And next task is to joint both sides together by welding them. Here we go. Both sides have been welded. This side is primary of 240 volt as intended. And that side is secondary of 225 volt or so, isolation side. However, it can be arranged other way around, and the result will be different. A 3 amperes fuse has been installed on primary side, and so has isolation side. This sticker emphasizes the capacity of this transformer, and also like mentioned earlier, this side used as primary of 240 volt. Then isolation side would be 225 volt or so. This paper has covered something. No worries at the moment. I will show you later. 2 meters have been connected to the transformer already. A clamp meter on the left is to measure live power's voltage. And a multimeter on the right is to measure isolation's secondary voltage. Switched live power on. You can see, at the moment, the voltage of live power is a bit higher than normal of 240 volt. And so is the voltage of isolation side as it should be. The reason to use an isolation transformer is the safety concern. Do not touch the live wire, otherwise we will get electric shock. However, with an isolation transformer, on the isolation side, you can touch any singed wire without electric shock. I leave to you for the reason. Touching the bare wire now. And no problem at all. But never, never, ever touch the two bare wires together. A globe with 240 volt and 100 watt has been connected to the isolation side. A clamp meter with AC current function selected and a multimeter with AC voltage function selected have been connected already. Switched live power on. Let AC current indicated by clamp meter stabilize. Right now the globe's voltage is 224 volt. And its current is 0.18 ampere. As primary voltage we have already known, 248 volt. Primary AC current is 0.92 ampere. So the efficiency of power consumption for the transformer is 224 volt times 0.18 ampere over 248 volt times 0.92 ampere equals 40.32 over 228.16 equals 0.177 equals 17.7%. Incidentally, the transformer has been turned around 180 degree, which means previous isolation side now is primary side. That paper is covering current isolation side. For this arrangement, the voltage in primary is the same as the voltage in secondary isolation. These wires are the isolation side now. Switched power on. The voltage on the left, primary, is 244 volt. And the voltage on the right, isolation, is 241 volt. Although two sides' voltages are not exactly the same, only a few volts difference. It is quite okay with this tolerance. Isolation transformer and associated accessories have been fixed on a piece of the board. A few wires have been properly connected already. On the left, it is input of 240 volt plug. On the right, they are the output socket and switches. Red in color is live switch, and green in color is isolation output switch. Then covering them by this DIY transformer cover. There is a sticker for the isolation transformer's details. The LED switch on the left is for live, LED switch on the right is for isolation, and there are markings on their top. Now whole thing is ready for the load testing. The isolation socket has been connected to globe, and a fan is the load. Switched live switch on, then it's LED on. Switched isolation switch on, then it's LED on. The globe and fan working well. Going to show you the one of practical examples of using an isolation transformer for operational safety concern as shown here. This IC power circuit board has been plugged to isolation socket. Switched live. Then isolation on. During measurement or diagnostics by using a multimeter, your fingers might unintentionally contact the circuit board on the high voltage part. As long as touch the one part only. likes this. You would not get electric shock. That is the advantage of using an isolation transformer in this circumstance. Now you've known how to DIY an isolation transformer by utilized recycled microwave oven transformers. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment and subscribe if you've enjoyed the video. Your encouragement is my motivation.